Want to monitor and secure employees who work from home? With CurrentWare's remote workforce management software, you can improve employee productivity, data security, and business intelligence with advanced awareness and control over how technology is used in your organization. After completing this tutorial, you will be able to remotely update your CurrentWare security policies and monitor the computer activities of your remote workers from the convenience of the CurrentWare console. Today, I will cover two key ways to deploy CurrentWare for remote workers. 1. Using port forwarding to connect offsite devices to an on-premises CurrentWare server. And 2. Deploying the CurrentWare server to a self-managed cloud virtual machine. For more information, you can visit the self-serve knowledge base at currentware.com/support or get in touch with the CurrentWare support team at currentware.com/contact. Before the tutorials, I'd like to go over how CurrentWare works. CurrentWare operates on a client-server model. The CurrentWare client is a software agent that collects computer activity data and enforces security policies on the device it is installed on. The CurrentWare server accepts and stores data from the CurrentWare clients and pushes out security policies to your managed devices. The CurrentWare console is where you'll manage your security policies and review the computer activity data of your remote workers. The CurrentWare console and server will be installed on a computer, server, or cloud-based virtual machine. After you set up the CurrentWare console and server, you will install the CurrentWare client on each computer that you would like to monitor and control. To monitor and manage these client computers when they're taken off-site, you'll need to connect the CurrentWare clients to the CurrentWare server through port forwarding or a VPN. Once the clients are installed on your users' computers and connected to the CurrentWare server, they will appear in the web console where you can run reports on their computer activities and apply your desired security policies. As a backup, each CurrentWare client has its own local database that stores user activity data and security policies. Should your remote employee lose connection with your network, their computer can still be monitored and restricted. Once they reconnect to the CurrentWare server, any security policy updates will be applied and their user activity data will be automatically uploaded. With that out of the way, let's go over the first method for monitoring remote employees with CurrentWare. This section will teach you how to monitor remote employees when you have the CurrentWare server installed on an on-site computer or server. To do this, you'll configure port forwarding rules that connect the CurrentWare clients to the CurrentWare server over a static public IP address. While we will be focusing on port forwarding for this tutorial, a VPN may also be used to establish a connection between your remote worker's computer and your company's network. To use a VPN in this way, you'll need to ensure that your network topology allows the CurrentWare client to connect to the CurrentWare server by IP address. The key advantage of using port forwarding over a VPN is that you can get real-time computer activity data from your remote workers without straining your VPN's bandwidth. This is ideal for remote teams that struggle with bandwidth overload when all their employees are connected to the VPN simultaneously. As a bonus, with port forwarding, your employees' computer activity data and security policies are kept up to date no matter what internet connection they use. To begin, Mike will show you how to install the CurrentWare console and server. Later in this tutorial, we will install the CurrentWare client on your remote employee's computer and use port forwarding rules to connect them to this server.
Hey everyone, this is Mike here. I'm the technical specialist within CurrentWare. For this part, you will need the CurrentWare setup file, which I currently have highlighted. If you do not have this file, you can go to currentware.com/download and fill out the form. Once we open it up here, we're just going to press next. Here, you'll be able to see the licensing agreement, so you have to accept the terms of the licensing agreement and select next. Here, you can see we're installing the console and the server, and it also shows the location of where it will be installed. Hit next. Here, all four of the solutions are selected, so we're just going to hit install. This will install the CurrentWare console. Great, we can see the installation is complete, and now it's going to create the SQL database. Now, you're going to be prompted to create an account. This account is how you will log into your CurrentWare console. Once you've created the username, click Add Operator. Here you can see the recommended exclusions for any third-party antiviruses. You can see there's three EXEs here and a couple ports to make sure that your CurrentWare software will run optimally. Next, here we're just going to finish up and it will launch the CurrentWare web console for you. And it prompts you to log in. This login will be the login that it prompts you to create during the installation steps.
All right, thanks Mike. Now that you've installed the CurrentWare server and console, it's time to configure inbound port forwarding rules in your router. These port forwarding rules will be used to send traffic from your remote employee's CurrentWare clients to the CurrentWare server. On your router, forward the following port traffic to the static public IP address of your CurrentWare server computer. Ports 8990 all the way to 8998, TCP and UDP. Ports 1433 and 1434, TCP and UDP. And finally, port 443, TCP and UDP. In order for port forwarding to work, you'll need to ensure that your CurrentWare server is on a network that has a static public IP address. This can be obtained from your internet service provider. For instructions on how to set up port forwarding for your specific router, please refer to the instructions from your manufacturer. Next, you need to use the SQL Server Configuration Manager to allow network connectivity on TCP port 1433. To do this, you'll need to launch the SQL Server Configuration Manager, expand the SQL Server Network Configuration, select Protocols, right-click on the option TCP IP, and select Properties. Click on the IP Addresses tab, scroll down to IP All, then, for TCP port, put in 1433. Now that you've prepared the CurrentWare server, it's time to deploy the CurrentWare clients to your employees' computers. If you already have CurrentWare clients deployed and you need to redirect them to a different server, please visit CurrentWare.com/support and search for How do I redirect the CurrentWare client to another CurrentWare server? There are multiple ways to deploy the CurrentWare client. For this tutorial, I will show you the local client installation. This is the simplest installation to do, as it just requires you to run the cwclientsetup.exe file. For large-scale deployments, you can also use group policies or a dedicated third-party software deployment tool. Alright, let's get started. To install the CurrentWare client on your employee's computer, simply run the cwclientsetup.exe file. Here, you'll see that it asks for an IP address or computer name. For this setup, you'll put in the static public IP address of the CurrentWare server's network. Click Next, then click Install. And that's it. All that's left to do is restart the computer. If there are any issues connecting the CurrentWare clients to the CurrentWare server, please ensure that the public IP address of your CurrentWare server network is static, and verify that your firewall is not blocking the following TCP and UDP ports. Ports 8990 to 8998, 1433, 1434, and 443. Depending on your antivirus software, CurrentWare's tracking features may get it falsely flagged as a potentially unwanted program. For the best results, you should exclude all the CurrentWare components from your antivirus program. For more information, please search for antivirus at CurrentWare.com/support. Now that the clients are installed and connected to the CurrentWare server, your employees' devices and user accounts will appear in the web console, where you can run reports on their computer activities and apply your desired security policies. To access the web console within the local area network of the CurrentWare server, simply open the web browser of your choice and enter your CurrentWare server's static public IP address or host name into the browser URL bar, followed by :8998. Then, type in the operator username and password you created during the installation. In a standard installation, the web console is only accessible to devices within your local area network. To access the web console remotely from an off-network device, you'll need to make one last change. On the machine with the CurrentWare server and console installed, browse to the following directory: C, Program Files x86, CurrentWare, CW Web Console, Web Console. In this folder, search for a file named app-config.json. Right-click on it and select Open With, then find Notepad. With the app-config.json file open in Notepad, you will see a line of text with a pre-populated API URL. Replace the existing IP address or hostname you see here with the static public IP address of the machine that's hosting the CurrentWare server. Finally, save your changes. That's it. Now that your inbound port forwarding rules are in place and the app-config.json file is configured properly, you will be able to remotely access your CurrentWare web console even when you're away from the local area network of the CurrentWare server. To do so, simply enter your static public IP address followed by :8998 in the address bar of a web browser. Next, I will show you how to deploy CurrentWare to the cloud. This setup is similar to a standard on-premises deployment, except instead of using an on-site computer or server to host the CurrentWare server, you'll create a virtual machine on the cloud platform of your choice. To deploy CurrentWare to the cloud, you'll need to first configure the virtual machine to accept CurrentWare traffic. Install the CurrentWare server on the virtual machine. Deploy the CurrentWare clients on the computers you would like to monitor and control. and configure the CurrentWare clients to connect to the CurrentWare server using the static public IP address of the cloud-based virtual machine. All right, let's get started. First, you need to create a virtual machine on the cloud platform of your choice. For this example, we will be using Azure, but you can also use another cloud service provider such as Google Cloud Platform or Amazon Web Services. At the time of this recording, CurrentWare is exclusively for monitoring and managing employees on Windows computers. For the most up-to-date system requirements, please visit CurrentWare.com/support/system-requirements. To create a Windows virtual machine in Azure, follow these steps. 1. Log into your Microsoft Azure portal. 2. In the search bar, type Virtual Machines. Under Services, select Virtual Machines. On the Virtual Machines page, click Create, then select Virtual Machine from the drop-down menu. Next, create a virtual machine with the following configurations. Under the Basics tab, enter your desired virtual machine name, Windows image, and instance size. Under the Administrator account, provide a username and a password. Later on, you will use these credentials to log into the virtual machine. Under Inbound Port Rules, choose Allow Selected Ports, and then select RDP, port 3389, and HTTPS, port 443, from the dropdown. Then, confirm the licensing checkbox before moving on to the next tab. Under the Disks tab, select your desired operating system disk type and encryption type. In this case, we'll use a standard HDD and the default encryption settings. Under the Networking tab, go to the Public IP section and click on Create New. This will create a public IP address for your virtual machine. When you are ready, click on the Review and Create button at the bottom of the page to create your virtual machine. Once your virtual machine is created, you will find the static IP address under Properties. Take note of the IP address because you'll need it for your CurrentWare client deployment. Now that you've created your virtual machine, we're going to connect to it via RDP so you can configure it to accept traffic from your CurrentWare server and clients. Here's how. First, log into your Azure portal. Then, go into Virtual Machines. Click on the name of your virtual machine, and from the left menu under Settings, select Connect. Under the RDP tab, choose the appropriate IP address and port number. In most cases, the default IP address and port should be used. Next, select Download RDP File. Open the Download RDP file and select Connect when prompted. You will get a warning that the RDP file is from an unknown publisher. This is expected and is not a cause for concern in this case. When prompted for your credentials, enter the username and password you created earlier. Then, select OK. If a certificate error comes up, you can select Yes to continue. Now that you're connected to the virtual machine, here are the changes you need to make to allow it to accept traffic between your CurrentWare server and clients. On your Azure portal, select your virtual machine. From the left menu under Settings, select Networking. Click on the button Add Inbound Port Rule. From the Service menu, choose Custom. Enter the destination port range 8990 to 8998, 1433, and 1434. Set the priority to any number you prefer. Finally, give it a name, and then click Add. With these settings, your virtual machine is all set to allow traffic to flow freely between the CurrentWare server and client. Next, Mike will show you how to install the CurrentWare server and console on the virtual machine. After that, we will deploy the CurrentWare clients to your employees' computers.
Hey everyone, this is Mike here. I'm the technical specialist within CurrentWare. For this part, you will need the CurrentWare setup file, which I currently have highlighted. If you do not have this file, you can go to currentware.com/download and fill out the form. Once we open it up here, we're just going to press Next. Here, you'll be able to see the licensing agreement, so you have to accept the terms of the licensing agreement and select Next. Here, you can see we're installing the console and the server, and it also shows the location of where it will be installed. Hit Next. Here, all four of the solutions are selected. So we're just going to hit Install. This will install the CurrentWare console. Great, we can see the installation is complete, and now it's going to create the SQL database. Now, you're going to be prompted to create an account. This account is how you will log into your CurrentWare console. Once you've created the username, click Add Operator. Here you can see the recommended exclusions for any third-party antiviruses. You can see there's three EXEs here and a couple ports to make sure that your CurrentWare software will run optimally. Next, here we're just going to finish up and it will launch the CurrentWare Web Console for you. It prompts you to log in. This login will be the login that it prompts you to create during the installation steps.
All right, thanks, Mike. Now that you've prepared the CurrentWare server, it's time to deploy the CurrentWare clients to your employees' computers. If you already have CurrentWare clients deployed and you need to redirect them to a different server, please visit CurrentWare.com/support and search for "How do I redirect the CurrentWare client to another CurrentWare server?" There are multiple ways to deploy the CurrentWare client. For this tutorial, I will show you the local client installation. This is the simplest installation to do, as it just requires you to run the cwclientsetup.exe file. For large-scale deployments, you can also use group policies or a dedicated third-party software deployment tool. Alright, let's get started. To install the CurrentWare client on your employee's computer, simply run the cwclientsetup.exe file. Here, you'll see that it asks for an IP address or computer name. For this setup, you'll put the static public IP address of your virtual machine. Click Next, then click Install. And that's it. All that's left to do is restart the computer. If there are any issues connecting the CurrentWare clients to the CurrentWare server, please ensure that the public IP address of your CurrentWare server network is static, and verify that your firewall is not blocking the following TCP and UDP ports. Ports 8990 to 8998, 1433, 1434, and 443. Depending on your antivirus software, CurrentWare's tracking features may get it falsely flagged as a potentially unwanted program. For the best results, you should exclude all of the CurrentWare components from your antivirus program. For more information, please search for antivirus at CurrentWare.com/support. Now that the clients are installed and connected to the CurrentWare server, your employees' devices and user accounts will appear in the web console, where you can run reports on their computer activities and apply your desired security policies. In a standard installation, the web console is only accessible to devices within your local area network. To access the web console remotely from an off-network device, you'll need to make one last change. On the machine with the CurrentWare server and console installed, browse to the following directory. C. Program Files x86. CurrentWare. CW Web Console. Web Console. In this folder, search for a file named app-config.json. Right-click on it and select Open With. Then, find Notepad. With the app-config.json file open in Notepad, you will see a line of text with a pre-populated API URL. Replace the existing IP address or hostname you see here with the static public IP address of the machine that's hosting the CurrentWare server. Finally, save your changes. That's it. Now that your inbound port forwarding rules are in place and the app-config.json file is configured properly, you will be able to remotely access your CurrentWare web console even when you're away from the local area network of the CurrentWare server. To do so, simply enter your static public IP address followed by :8998 in the address bar of a web browser. That's it for today. If you have any questions, our support team is here to help. Simply reach out to us at CurrentWare.com/contact or visit CurrentWare.com/support to access our self-serve knowledge base. If you're not already familiar with CurrentWare, you can learn more about our products and get a free trial at CurrentWare.com/products. See you next time.